Hello, and welcome to another release of Intel Graphics Performance Analyzers. I'm Justin Harden, engineer on the GPA team, here to give you the highlights of our 2024.1 public release. We will begin with UIUX Improvements and Graphics Frame Analyzer. First, we have added a progress bar indicator when exporting metrics values to a CSV file. In Frame Analyzers, you can export metrics for selected draw calls or for the full frame. For complex workloads and with many metrics counters selected, export could take some time. If you move your cursor over the indicator, the tooltip will show the exact percentage of the export progress. While the export is in progress, you may continue to interact with the rest of the UI elements, but metrics in the Metrics tab will not update until export is complete. Next, we have introduced a new grouping category for the bar chart. API calls can now be grouped by shader sets. Shader sets are also available under chart region annotations. Lastly, the metrics presets list now shows user-defined presets separated from the system profiles. This helps you to see presets which you've created for your specific profiling needs. Moving on to features. In the previous release, we added support for displaying and modifying parameters for variable rate shading. This release adds support for three additional non-PSO states, viewports, scissorrects, and blend factor states. State modification is possible by editing the structures directly in the UI. Once you make an edit, you will immediately see metrics results for the altered states or visible changes in the final render target for some draws. Let's talk about Intel GPA Framework. We made some improvements to our metadata extractor, specifically when extracting shaders. Shader InfoStruct has a new member to expose shader compile flags for D3D shaders. Next, client code can request IHV-specific isocode for a shader info, provided there is driver support for it. Be sure to update your drivers. Shader ISA is currently available for D3D12 and D3D11-based applications only. Finally, a word on deprecation. Going forward, we are dropping support for pre-Gen 12 Intel GPUs. Frame analysis might still work on older generations, but future issues will not be fixed. Shader profiling is not available for pre-Gen 12 hardware. Support is fully dropped for DirectX 9 and 10 based applications. And support for GPA on Ubuntu will not be available. Those are the top highlights for the Intel GPA 2024.1 release. Take a look at the release notes and try out these features and more with our free downloads of Intel GPA and Intel GPA Framework by following the links in the description. Remember to like this video and subscribe to the Intel Software YouTube channel for more Intel GPA news and updates.